Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, I want to show you how to fill cells in Numbers. So I'm often asked, how do you fill cells in Numbers? For instance, you may want to copy and then paste a number into multiple cells. You may want to have it automatically fill as you expand a spreadsheet. There's all sorts of different ways to fill cells in Numbers. So let's look at them all. So here's a standard blank spreadsheet, and the most common thing you may want to do is simply fill a series of cells with the same number. So here I've put a number into a cell. I'm going to select it and then select Edit and then Copy or Command C. Then I'm going to select a series of cells. I can do that by selecting one then Shift selecting another. You could also drag the little dot here at the bottom right hand corner and select your area. Then I'm going to Edit and Paste or Command V. And you can see it simply fills all those cells with that same number. I can select an area, paste it, and it will do it like that. Now this also works if you have a series of cells and even if there's formulas in them. So for instance, this first cell here is just the number, and there's another number, and then this third cell here is actually a formula adding these two together. Now if I select all of them, I Command Shift and select all three there, and I Command C copy, then I select, say, the cell below that and Shift select there to select that whole area and I paste, you can see it pastes it all in. It's not pasting the number there in the last cell, it's actually pasting the formula, shifting it down as you would expect. So I can undo that there and then say select only that cell, copy, select a bunch of cells here, paste, and you can see it's a bunch of zeros because say this one here is trying to add these two together. I can put values in them and you can see it will adjust according to those values. Now let's do this with taking the entire table into consideration. So I've got a large table here. I'm going to shrink it down to just the size I need. I'm going to insert a extra footer row here. So it's very common to want to have totals. So for instance, let's shrink this all the way so I just have one sample row here and put this as the sum of everything in B. And then I'm going to actually copy that and paste that here. And see, it's sum of B and sum of C and sum of D. And then I'm going to make this a formula where it takes this number and adds this number to it. So now I can put two values in here. And you can see it fills it in properly. Now what would be nice is if it automatically filled in this formula here as I expanded. And if I drag down and expand, you can see that's exactly what it does. It's smart enough to realize that I've got a formula here and it's going to add that to every row that I add. So as I increase the table size, it will just add it in. So I can start adding in new numbers and it would automatically do that. And I can shrink the table back down, say if I added too many, and it will automatically do it if I just select it properly. There. Oh, it actually looks like it's locked in place. So I can't actually remove these rows here. I can only add new ones to it, which is probably the best way to do it. You could still select and I'm sure delete these. You can see I'm deleting the selected rows. So it's not going to let you easily remove data that you've added, but you can still do it by deleting. So the automatic filling here, you can see how well it works as long as you set the table up correctly. Now you also have some other options. For instance, if I have a number here in the table, I can select that number and a bunch of other cells and then I can go to Insert Fill and you can see Fill Down has been selected and I can copy that number to all of them. Look what happens if I put two different numbers here and I select a whole bunch of cells, then I Insert Fill and Fill Down and you can see that it's going to actually always take that first cell. Likewise, if I did Fill and Fill Up, it'll take that bottom cell and fill it up. So you want to be careful when doing that. Likewise, I can fill across. So I can fill right and I can put those numbers there as well. And this works for formulas, which of course is where it really is useful. So if I put this formula here, oops, that's good. There. And now I select and I say Insert Fill Down. You can see it's done the same thing as the copy and paste would have done, but just another way of doing it using the menu, insert fill. Now here's something really cool that you can do. You can fill with patterns. And it works pretty intuitively. For instance, if I put the word January there and I simply grab the bottom right hand corner of that and drag down, look what happens. All the months appear and it will even repeat. So the same thing will happen, say, for days of the week. Or if I were to do, say, a pattern like 1, 2, 3 and then select all of it like that and then drag, it knows the pattern and will repeat it. And you can do this horizontally or vertically. You can even do it with text, for instance, A, B, and I can select both of those and drag down and it will continue the alphabet. Now one more note about filling in formulas. Say I want a formula here that's this cell plus this cell, and I also want to have a constant. I want to add something automatically, like a sales charge to a list of sales, and I want to put that number here. So you can see B2 plus C2 plus G2. Now if I were to copy this and paste it below, you can see that's B3 plus C3 plus G3. But I want this to be a constant. I want to put a number here like 1.5 and have that always added to each one. What I'm going to do is go into this formula and I'm going to click on the G2 in the formula and change it to make it an absolute row and column. So that means it's absolute. It will always link to G2 no matter where I copy and paste this. So I'm going to copy and paste it below here. Matter of fact, I'm going to do it a bunch of times. And you can see it's always 1.5. It's going to do, say, 4 plus 9, or 4 plus 5, 6 plus, and just do a whole bunch of different ones to fill in. And you can see it's always adding in. There's B2 plus C2 plus G2, then B3 plus C3 plus G2. So it's always going to use this number in every version of this formula. It's not going to go sequentially down as I copy and paste the formula. So that really comes in handy for a lot more advanced stuff. So there's lots of different ways to be able to fill in cells in numbers without having to actually enter in the value over and over again. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.